I've been using battery power drill for a long time. Now is the time to change the battery. I thought the new battery is too expensive, so I decided to use AC power instead. I bought this inexpensive yet powerful switching power supply from Amazon. It converts the AC power to DC, and I take the output of it to feed the drill. I found it's good, and from now on, most of the time I'm going to use AC power. Not only is cheap, also it's light. It's much lighter than the battery. Just anytime, if it is necessary, I can still switch back to battery. It's so simple. Here is how I made it possible.
I searched online for a power supply and I found this one. I can adjust the output to 18 volt and 20 amp current is enough for my drill. For AC input, I take a computer power cord, cut off female end connector, strip the end of wires, matching up each wire with the line, neutral and ground, and solder a connector to each wire. Then screw it to the respective place as shown to the right in the photo. As for the DC output, in order to reduce the power loss along the line, I take two-wire power cord, parallel connect power supply to the drill. I cut off their connectors, strip the end of wires, and solder connector to one end of each wire, and screw it to the respective positive and negative place, as shown to the left in the photo. To feed DC output to the drill, I want to make use of the shell of the battery assembly, and I want to get rid of the heavy battery cells inside. There are five special kinds of screws holding the assembly. I don't have that kind of screwdriver, neither is there in the market. I was left no choice but to break the screws. I used a reciprocal saw to do the job and it turned out easy. Don't have to cut too deep, just enough to break the screws and the job is done. Separate the shell with the battery cells. Cut the connector out from the battery cells. Put the connector to its location on the shell. Now solder the power cord connecting the power supply DC output, making sure the polarities are correct and there is no short circuit. Then use silicone glue, fix the connector to the base. It's the time to put pieces together. I use construction glue to fill up the gap between these two pieces. The glue stick the two pieces together very well. And after that, I use a black tape to cover it up.
This is the power adapter I made to connect the drill to the DC power supply. After carefully check out the wiring, I'm ready to give it a test. But before that, I must not forget to set the AC input voltage to 110 volt through a switch on the right side of the power supply. Plug the AC power cord to the power outlet. Adjust the output voltage to 18 volts. Measure the voltage on the adapter. Now plug the power adapter to the drill. And it's ready to go to work. I have been using this modified drill for a while now. I enjoy the benefit from it. Power, lightweight, and never have to change the battery again. Thank you for watching. Any comment is welcome.